Hi students, hope you all got an idea about normalization and the various normal forms. First normal form, second normal form and the third normal form. Next, we are starting with the third normal form, general definitions of second and third normal forms. Okay. So, first normal form, second normal form and the 3NF we have already discussed. And the next is Boyce code normal form. That also I have mentioned in the introductory part. Okay, so before that I would like to start with the topic where we posed in the earlier session, general definitions of second and third normal forms. So as you all know, first normal form means it depends on the atomicity. Atomic values are only allowed in the schema. That is what you mean by first normal form. Here the general definition of 2NF states that it depends only on full functional dependency. That is, suppose a schema R is in second normal form, if every non-prime attribute A in R is not partially depend on any key of R. Okay, so every non-prime attribute should be fully dependent on the keys of R. That is a general definition of second normal form. And third normal form, you have to remember this, a relation schema R is in third normal form if whenever an FD X to A holds in R, then either X is a super key of R or A is a prime attribute of R. Okay, suppose X identifies A. Okay, if such a functional dependency exists, either X should be a super key of R or A is a prime attribute of R. Okay, then we can say such a dependency exists there, and that is in 3NF. Okay. So let's see an example. Here is a schema in which property ID, county name, lot, area, price and tax rate. That is, a schema depends on some lots. Okay. So every property is having a property ID of which a county name, a name is there, and a lot number is there for each plots. Okay, so county name and lot are togetherly a primary key, or we can say it's a, these all are candidate keys of which property ID is set as the primary key, and this county name and lot means it can only togetherly identify. That means suppose county name can be repeated or lot number can be repeated. Okay, so we can only identify a particular row only with the help of county name along with the lot number. That is the schema given here. And some non-prime attributes are there, area, price and a tax rate. Here, four FDs are existing. First FD, functional dependency 1 exists here. That says that property ID identifies these all attributes, this candidate keys and all these non-prime attributes. Okay, so there is not any problem right now, and that means here we are just dividing, no atomic values here, county name is here, lot number is there, so FD1 doesn't have any problem. Okay, second one is FD2, in which this is a group key. Okay, this is another key. Okay, that means if this property ID is a unique value, so it can uniquely identify each and every tuple. So this FD1 doesn't have any problem. Second FD says that county name and lot identifies, they togetherly identifies property ID, area, price and tax rate. Okay, so here also it says it is having a full functional dependency here, since county name along with the lot ID is used here. Here, FD3 in which partial dependency is existing. Okay, that is out of county name and lot number, we have only taken this county name to identify the tax rate. Suppose Angamali, if the county name is Angamali, okay. So Angamali is having a particular tax rate, okay. So this can be existing, but the problem is this FD3 is against our 2NF. Okay, that is here partial functional dependency exists. We have removed one key from this two group key. Okay, the county name and the lot are group keys. Okay, out of which you have removed one key. So here partial dependency is existing in FD3. FD4 says that area identifies price. Okay, that's not, doesn't have any problem, I think so. Okay, so area is a non-prime attribute, price is also non-attribute. Suppose if we are normalizing a schema, first we have to normalize it to 1NF. So here all FDs approves first normal form. Okay, that means no non-atomic values are here, simple values are here, not any group values or multi-valued attribute or nested relations or composite attributes, not any such attribute is existing in any of these four FDs. So it satisfies first normal form. Second, this, the next aim is we have to then normalize it to 2NF. So this is in 2NF. Since the primary key identifies this one, okay, so it doesn't have any problem. This FD2 also approves the second normal form, since you are using full functional dependency here, and FD3 is against the second normal form. So our next aim is to decompose this relation into 2NF. Okay, so here we have decomposed this county name and tax rate, and also we need to preserve that functional dependency. So county name has been removed, not removed, it has been propagated to another relation, and this tax rate, which is not any prime attribute, so we have removed it from this particular schema and make it into a new relation. So county name identifies tax rate FD3, that is removed from here. So here only one key which identifies another non-prime attribute, that is in 2NF and in 1NF, okay, and also in 3NF, okay. So next problem is, these two doesn't have any problem. The thing is, FD4 area identifies price. Okay, so here what we are doing here is, this property ID identifies area and this area identifies price. That means we have seen in the 3NF example in the previous session, that is the department number. Okay, same case. That means transitive dependency is existing here. Suppose area is a prime attribute, it doesn't have any candidate key, it doesn't have any problem. Okay, here property ID identifies county name and lot. Okay, this county name and lot togetherly identifies area and price, that is also in 3NF also, because non-transitive dependency is existing there, because county name and lot are candidate keys. But the problem here is, area is not a prime attribute, so that is against the rule of 3NF. So we need to decompose this into two relations. So let's see, we have again removed it. So already so we are taking this lots one. Okay, here lots has been divided into lots one and lots two, out of which lots one doesn't satisfy, that is this FD4 is not satisfied in this lots one, which is against the 3NF. So we need to decompose this LOTS 1. So LOTS 1 is again divided into LOTS 1A and LOTS 1B. Okay. So area is propagated to another relation and price is removed from there. So area price FD4 is preserved here, and also area can identify its price, that is in 3NF. So first you have a relation LOTS which is in 1NF, and you satisfied in the next session that is 2NF, that is you decomposed into two LOTS, 1 and LOTS 2. FD3 has been removed to a new relation, and next we need to satisfy 3NF. So again LOTS 1 we have divided or decomposed into LOTS 1A and LOTS 1B, and this LOTS 2 is existing. So in these three schemas togetherly, we can say FD1 and FD2 in LOTS 1A, in LOTS 1B FD4 is preserved, and LOTS 2 FD3 is preserved. This is the progressive normalization of LOTS into a 3NF design. Okay, hope you all understand it. Next is, what is Boyce code normal form? Boyce code normal form says that a relation schema R is in Boyce code normal form if whenever an FD X identifies A holds in R, then X is a super key of R. It is same as you said in 3NF, but the only difference is only one condition is here. X is a super key of R. But in the general definition of 3NF, you are having two conditions for 3NF. Either X is a super key of R or A is a prime attribute of R. That is a condition in 3NF which is again modified here. That is, only one condition satisfies here. X is a super key of R. Then only we can say X identifies A which is in BCNF. Each normal form is strictly stronger than the previous one. That is, every 2NF relation is in 1NF, every 3NF relation is in 2NF, and every BCNF relation is in 3NF. There exist relations that are in 3NF but not in BCNF. Hence, BCNF is considered as stronger form of 3NF. So that is proposed by both Boyce and Cord. So the name Boyce Cord normal form. So our aim is to make our relation schema up to BCNF. If not, possibly 3NF is needed for every schema design. Okay. So see, this is an example, LOTS 1, previous example. I have included one more FD in this LOTS 1A. Okay, LOTS 1 is this one, FD and FD1 and FD2 in the previous example. We have added one more FD here, that is area. Area identifies quantity. Okay, so area identifies quantity. According to 3NF, what you said? You said that X identifies A, means 3NF says that either X is a super key. X means here X is area and A is quantity name. Okay, so either area is a super key or A, that is the quantity name, is a prime attribute. Okay, so according to this, quantity name is a prime attribute, a lot is also a prime attribute, candidate keys. Area is a non-prime attribute, but area identifies quantity name, means since quantity name is a prime attribute, you can say it is in 3NF, but it is not in BCNF, because BCNF states only one condition, X is a super key of R, which is not satisfied here, area, which is a non-prime attribute. So we normalize it into two relations, property ID, area, load, and quantity name has been removed from there, and area propagated here, area is identifying here, area identifies quantity name. But here the problem is FD2 has been lost here. Okay, since continuum has been removed from our original relation.